So right away it becomes apparent that Muck is trying to break the mold a little bit by just throwing you right in the middle of the action. Like, instead of actually introducing you to the characters and everything and then letting them die off one by one, people are already dead and we're just introduced to the survivors here. Ooh, that's so different. And then during the main titles, we get some random chick running around in the middle of a field without a top on because this movie's not trying to be gratuitous like other slasher movies, it's different. And then this guy tries to offer some clever commentary by pointing out the fact that they're in a horror movie. He says, "Oh, I'm gonna die soon anyway because I've been injured." And this girl's gonna die because she's annoying. This girl's too sexy. She's obviously gonna die. He's the sweet boyfriend, so he's gonna die. But she's obviously gonna live because she's like the sassy, nice girl, and she's like wearing more clothes than the other girls. She's obviously gonna be the final survivor. I mean, that's also why we're never gonna get to see her tits. Also, I wish that I had a small dick in this instance. I'm trying really, really, really hard to be funny right now. Dude, shut the fuck up already. Yes, that's exactly what he needs to fucking do. I really cannot wait to see this guy die. This girl says she's gonna go upstairs and then some spooky, ominous music starts playing. Oh no! But this girl goes downstairs! Oh no! And then this dude's down there who doesn't do anything because she's the token final girl, so nothing bad's gonna happen to her. Yeah. So then the nice boyfriend guy goes for help and he, like, gets to a bar where he goes into the bathroom and takes his shirt off and freshens up. Isn't he supposed to be, like, calling for help or some shit? There are people there, but I don't know. I guess they're trying to fucking appeal to the female audience now. Why the fuck would this movie have a female audience anyway? Or any audience, for that matter? Oh, but don't worry, dudes. There's more ne unnecessarily topless ladies going on into the other bathroom because this movie is so different. This is clearly a thinking man's slasher film. Finally, after just jacking around for 5 minutes, boyfriend guy asks to use someone's phone. And she's like, buy me a drink first. And he's like, okay, sure, my friends might be dying. Meanwhile, this one girl's taking a shower. Okay. But then she looks outside and, what the fuck's happening? And then she tries to leave the bathroom, but apparently just forgot that she was standing in a bathtub because she trips over and falls on her fucking face. Instead of falling unconscious, she runs downstairs where she meets that guy from the basement. This has to be like the least cool looking slasher I've ever seen. Seriously, what the fuck? And then we get to see this sloppy piece of editing where we get to see some ass. Face. Ass. Face. Ass. Face. Ass. Face. Ass. I'm not even trying to mess with it right now. That is seriously how they edited that moment. And then we get a bunch of talking. And then more talking. And talking. And talking. And talking. And talking. Wow. This is so riveting. Weren't there people like in a house being attacked? What the fuck? And then we get to see this hot chick like getting touched up in the bathroom, whatever. I mean, sure, it's kind of hot, but I could look up better things on Google. You know, I remember the way that I first heard about this movie was like a video where Greg Benson went to the Playboy Mansion and they were doing something to promote Muck. I really can't tell that this movie was produced by Playboy, can you? I mean, you would have never ever guessed that this movie was produced by Playboy magazine. But wait, hold on a minute. We get to see more ass! Wow! I really can't tell that this was produced by a girly mag. Seriously though, what the hell happened to the slasher movie I was just watching? This feels like a bunch of boring spring break bullshit. Wait a minute, here's a little bit of slasher movie activity. Oh shit. And the... damn it. You can tell that her boyfriend is trying really hard to get some help after some of their friends have already been killed. Anyway, soon after that, we get to see, like, a little more action as he's finally going back to the house to try to help his girlfriend. And then we get to see a little more something. I don't even know what the fuck's going on. By the way, listen to this really terrifying slasher movie music. John Carpenter ain't got shit on this soundtrack. Wait a minute, they're actually showing one of the final girl's tits now. After that one guy said, "We're never gonna get to see your tits." Damn, this movie totally caught me off guard with its clever writing. And then her sweet and caring boyfriend stops running back to the house to be a peeping Tom. I really could not care less about this movie by now. And then they show more stuff happening with the annoying douchebag from earlier, and I know this isn't a very good shot to pause it on, but neither are the rest of the shots in this scene. Like, you can barely tell what you're even looking at. I guess they're being attacked by some kind of cannibalistic tribesmen or some shit. Anyway, apparently this guy is being accompanied in his torment by that girl he said was annoying earlier, and honestly, they're not making even the slightest attempt to run away from these guys or even fight back. Like, she's just making these really half-assed attempts to rescue him while he just kind of sits there and acts completely useless. Actually, the best part of the scene is where one of the killers just gives them this look like, "God damn, were you dropped on your heads?" Then, in a shocking twist that nobody gives a shit about, it turns out that this stuff already happened, like, in the past. I remember earlier when the one girl who was taking the shower looked out the window and I was like, "Damn, what the hell's going on?" This is what was happening. The movie just rewound that because, yeah, apparently I wanted to see more of this story fleshed out. God damn, will this thing ever end? But wait, then the annoying douchebag actually kind of tries to get away from them, now that he's badly injured and has gasoline all over him. Wow. He couldn't even try the stop, drop, and roll method first? And then we watch Shower Girl just sit there and die. Yeah, because, you know, that needed to be seen. And then we get to see that other girl finally taking some action by running away, very slowly, through a field in her underwear. Fun fact, this is a Playboy movie. And then the boyfriend does some more running. Then his girlfriend gets thrown out a window. And then she dies. What a twist. And then this movie tries to do something that it has no right to do. It tries to get really sad as the boyfriend cries over her dead body after he took his good sweet time in making a failed attempt to get help and then stopped by a window to peep on some other woman. You know what? Fuck this movie. Especially given the fact that they never even did anything to really establish these people as characters except for the sloppy exposition given by that douchebag at the beginning. I mean, I get what they were trying to do by just throwing us in the middle of the action and just getting all of that bullshit out of the way, but still, I cannot attach myself to these characters. Especially when they go out of their way to act as careless about the situation as fucking possible. And then the boyfriend gets all mad and tells the whoever killed her that he'll kill them. Wow, this is so exciting. And then more action takes place, and again, I can't really tell. Okay, I guess he got thrown through a door or something. I really wouldn't mind seeing more gratuitous ass shots at this point. Wait a minute, is there seriously more than 30 minutes left in this thing? Fuck! And then some of that time is spent showing this very important scene where he continues crying over his girlfriend, who he did absolutely nothing to help.
I guess it wasn't such a good idea to buy her that drink.
And then we get to see more underwear girl. Okay, I'll settle for this. I will definitely take this over the stupid crying boyfriend. Ass. You know, I'll bet whoever made this movie really liked Texas Chainsaw 3D. I'll bet his only complaint about that movie was that it didn't contain enough gratuitous ass shots. And wasn't she just dry a minute ago? Fuck it. So then she hides in this barn for a few minutes and we get to see some gratuitous cleavage as well. Nice. And then she gets out of the barn where she just dicks around. You know, if they were gonna just throw us into the middle of the action at the beginning, they could have just kept the pace going throughout the film instead of adding all of this unnecessary filler, or better yet, just made this movie 10 minutes long. Seriously, I've shown you the majority of the slasher action already. Most of the movie is just this, just a bunch of slow bullshit. I mean, as nice as some of these girls are to look at, this isn't what I typically watch a slasher movie for. But wait, then as this girl is looking outward and everything, this guy comes from outward. How the hell could she not see him coming? I don't know, I feel like it's useless to be using my brain at this point. So then she valiantly kills him and how the fuck is his body being held up right now? Wait, no, too much brain, sorry. Then the sprinkler comes on because she wasn't wet enough already. Brought to you by Playboy Magazine. And then she washes off, but wasn't she just freezing cold earlier? Wait, no, too much brain, too much brain! Anyway, then we get back to those people from the bar because their story arc was so interesting. So then the killers start coming after them because why not? I actually kind of like this little strobe at it though. And then slow motion jiggling boobs. This is a Playboy movie. Honestly though, I'm glad that it cut back to these characters because at least there's more going on now. I mean, it's a little better than watching those other idiots just dick around. And I would ask how the hell the car got flipped over, but, you know, too much brain. And I spoke too soon. Now they're back to just dicking around and talking. And talking, and talking, and talking, and talking. And then they run into the boyfriend guy. Why isn't he dead already? Actually, it turns out that this is the boyfriend's cousin, apparently. That's who he was calling earlier when he was calling for help instead of, you know, the police or someone. And yeah, it's kind of stupid that I didn't realize that they were in a different bar than he was in before, but again, should I really be using my brain for this fucking movie? And then boyfriend guy starts crying like a little girl after he called his cousin and not the cops. Well, this is what you fucking get. By the way, check out some of this Oscar-worthy dialogue.
If it makes you feel any better, my car got tossed onto the hot chick I was hoping to bang tonight. How was it?
You can tell he's really sad about this human being who just died. And then the boyfriend continues crying over his girlfriend, who he really didn't do jack shit to help. And yeah, apparently the car got flipped on top of that one chick with the slow motion boobs, but again, they don't really show the process of the car getting flipped over. In fact, let me rewind a bit. Aha! They did another strobe at it! Yeah, could anyone else tell what the fuck just happened? I didn't think so. Then the cousin just goes into the house, which, by the way, is completely covered in blood, and he's just kind of indifferent to all of it. How is this guy a better choice than the fucking police? Too much brain. And then Underwear Girl comes back in. There's another killer out there. Anyway, shit starts hitting the fan, which is when these girls start to heroically scream their heads off. Friend Guy drops Underwear Girl, and then falls over. Hail the conquering hero! And then Underwear Girl runs out onto the upstairs balcony and screams her head off, because that's just a great way to hide from killers. God damn, these characters are fucking dumb. Surprise, she gets caught. And in the very next second, blood splatters. This is just bad editing. I know I'm no expert myself, but shit, I'm not getting paid to do this. This is like a movie with paid actors and everything. You'd think they would have given it a little more effort. So then the cousin gets pulled out the window in a way that's actually pretty cool. I mean, I would ask how the hell they were able to throw that rope through the second story window and around his neck, but, I mean, what are brains? Somehow, after getting pulled out the window, he still has the strength to fight these guys. Who needs brains when you can be a man? Having an injury after being choked half to death and pulled out of a second story window is for pussies. And then he has some badass manly dialogue to express.
Are you gonna pay for this shirt, creeper? You can't just buy one either. I had it made!
You tell him, Mr. Man. This movie has a 0% on Rotten Tomatoes. And then he walks away from this fire, which is about as well explained as the car being flipped over in slow motion, because this is an action movie now. Now you're a man! And then it turns out that Underwear Girl is still alive, which makes me wonder where the blood splatter came from, but too much brain. Which is when Mr. Man and that one chick just heroically run away. Alright. Who needs to be a hero when you can be a man? There's a difference, right? And the sweet, caring boyfriend follows them because he wants to be a man too. And then the movie decides to just slow down again as they keep walking for about 5 minutes. And then they start to have this lighthearted dialogue after they just allowed someone to die. Ha ha, we're sociopaths! Yay, they're being attacked again. And the lighting has completely changed for some reason. Too much brain? Seriously, did the sun just spontaneously appear out of nowhere? And then the cousin just drops another random one-liner saying, "Never call me again." Because duh, you should have gotten the police, they would have been more fucking capable. They probably would have saved Underwear Girl's life. Although I'm not so sure they could have been pulled out of a window by the neck and survived, like a real man. So then the other douche gets thrown against the shore of this marsh, and then just falls into the water. Okay, I guess he's dead. Then this man gets the upper hand on the killer. And then the movie gives us another emotional moment, which it has no right to play. It did not earn this. And then you think that these two are gonna get away when suddenly the water starts bubbling and the man just says, "This can't be good." And then it's over. So now you know the story of Muck. Don't watch this fucking movie.